Hi y'all, it's Anna with Always Right, and in today's video, I'm going to be doing a little pep talk for those of you that are in Act 2 of your book, or the muddled, messy middle. And at the end, I'll give you some tips to help you get through the middle. Now, right now, I am pretty close to getting out of my middle, and so I wanted to share the pep talk with you that I've been giving myself almost every time I get stuck on a chapter. I also wanted to share the tips and things I learned along the way, pushing and clawing and my way through the middle of my book. So let's get you pumped to write the middle of your book, to write Act 2. First off, I want to say congratulations on getting through Act 1. If you are in the process of writing your middle, no matter where on the scale you are, that's huge. You're already through the hardest part, which is continuing from Act 1 to Act 2. That's great. Like, give yourself a pat on the back for that. That is huge. So many people get through Act 1 and then they go, I'm done. Or they can't write anymore towards their book, or they just kind of get caught up doing it. So the fact that you're in the middle of your book, you're writing Act 2, you've pushed through, you're one of the survivors. Now we gotta get through Act 2. The middle is sometimes up to like 60% of your book. It is the biggest chunk to tackle. You can do this though. It'll be tough, I know it will, but you have already proven your worth by getting into the fray. You've already made it so far, like just a little bit more, just one more chapter. Just one more page. Just take it one word at a time. You got this. You can do this. Do you have a character that's giving you grief? Just throw him in a closet. Kill him. Just, you know, get him addicted to heroin. Just, Take your anger out on your characters. Inflict the pain you're going through of writing this middle on your characters. Heck, start a fight with your characters. Just have fun with it. Now that the you can do it is out of the way, let me give you some tips on how to do it. So I'm not just giving you the you can do it and then disappearing out of your life yet. I'm gonna give you some tips that helped me push through my just like, I don't know what I'm gonna do. I have no idea. I just look at this, it's the middle kind of moment. So if you are a pantser, this tip is for you. I'm a pantser, so this is what I use to get through. Look at your book as a whole up until now. Are there 3 to 5 main locations you keep visiting? For my character, it's her job, her apartment, and then her brother's trailer park. I establish a kind of conflict with every single location. With her job, it's always an internal conflict that gets resolved and it builds up my character. For her apartment, it's always a personal to person kind of conflict. She's always hashing something out with either her love interest or her brother. This is where the kind of like close relations conflict happens for my character. And then the last main location in my book is the trailer park. Now at the trailer park, I have a wide array of conflicts. I have inner conflicts, I have person to person, and then I have society to person conflicts. And it's just a lot of fun. If you've kind of picked out those key locations in your mind, look through the last 2 to 5 chapters you wrote. Is there one of your main locations that's missing? If there is, boom, there's your next chapter. Done. With this kind of pantsing method, I've really been able to develop my characters, develop my plot in an organic manner. For my outliners out there, hi, I'm really jealous of you. Can I have your autograph? I want you to just take a step back. You don't have to literally step away from your computer, but just kind of look at your book. Look at how much you have down and you know where you're going. You got this. You and your characters got this. And don't forget to look at the big picture on your book. I know it's pretty easy to get really bogged down in the teeny tiny little details, and this goes here, that goes there. Just take a moment, breathe, look at your book. You can do it. Now for a more general kind of tips, it works for pantsers, works for planners, let's get into them. So if you set a goal for yourself on writing, for example, my writing goal for June was 20,000 words. I then broke that down into 700 words a day, giving myself a little leeway, a little room to wiggle. But by breaking down 20,000 words, I wasn't working towards 20,000 words. Every day, I would wake up and work towards just 700. It's that easy. Also, if you reach your monthly goal, your weekly goal, your daily goal, there's nothing stopping you from keeping on. You still have more to go, trust me. And if you're on a roll, keep it going. Keep that momentum going. Remember, one of the hardest things about writing every day is starting, is remembering where you left off. So if you can overwrite your goal, cool. But like an example of me, I have a new daily goal of 2,100 words, but I look at it in the frame of I need to get three sets of 700. So instead of looking at my document going, oh man, I only have 300 words towards my 2,100 goal, that's only a seventh. I look at it and I go, okay, 300 out of 700, 400 more words, and I reach one of my goals. It seems tiny, but it really helps break down the book into achievable goals. Another note, stay hydrated. Drink water, coffee, soda, tea, alcoholic drinks. Just make sure that you always have a drink beside you. Because if you don't have a drink beside you and you're in the middle of a scene and you go, oh, I really need a drink, get up, get that drink, sit back down. Where was I? I've done this so many times. Just keep a drink beside you no matter what when you're writing. But if you're clumsy, put it in like one of those like to-go coffee containers. That way, if you knock it over, you have a few moments to get it before it destroys your computer and your life. And my last tip for getting through the middle is to never end on a new chapter. What I mean by this is if you complete chapter 26 and you've met your word goal and you're pretty tired and you're like, you know what? I'm done. Don't do it. Go ahead and write 50, 200 words towards that new chapter. One of the most intimidating things, especially when you're writing the middle, which can be hard and just like you don't want to do it, is looking at a blank page. Opening up a document and looking at a blank page for a new chapter. Go ahead and write 50 to 200 words towards that chapter. You'll thank yourself tomorrow. So this is one of my shorter videos. These are tips and tricks I remind myself of every single time I open my computer to start writing. And as for the motivation, I've kind of had to like say it to my dog a few times so that I could hear it out loud and be like, okay, we're good to go. So thank y'all so much for watching. If you liked this video, please like the video and feel free to subscribe. It's free. I put out new videos every Tuesday and Friday. My Tuesday videos are more kind of writing vlog videos, so you get to see the chaos that is me trying to write. Thank you all so much for watching. And as always, let's get writing. Bye.